The Robertson clan recently took home the Faith and Freedom Award for their hit reality TV series. Now two members of the Duck Dynasty are about to hit the big screen.
The Robertsons turned duck calls into a multi-million dollar empire, including a hit reality television series.
I'm reading from 1 Corinthians.
The family's faith is at the heart of their show, and it's front and center in this new film.
Fill in the papers I've just given you with three little words. God is dead.
God's Not Dead stars Kevin Sorbo of Hercules fame, and Willie and Korie Robertson play themselves.
So what do you say to people who are offended by your show because you openly pray to Jesus?
Hey, we're not trying to offend anybody, all right? As far as my praying to Jesus, my life and my whole eternity belongs to God. Jesus, that's eternal.
And that's it?
That's it. That's what we're going with.
Well, Willie and Korie are now joining us live from satellite from West Monroe, Louisiana. Hey, cousin, how you doing?
Hey, how are they clean-shaven Robertsons up there?
We're doing great. I've been reading about you guys in the paper. I hear you got a father that likes to speak his mind.
Yeah, he'll lay it out there. So he's not ashamed of his faith, and neither the rest of us, and we look at this as an opportunity to spread that faith, and being a part of this movie was part of that. And what a great movie. Korie and I were able to watch it, and it's a really good movie. I think people will be surprised at how well it's done, and the message is awesome, and can't wait till March 21st.
Okay, that's when the movie ends. How true to life is the plot of this movie?
It is. You know, they take a lot of situations, I think, that people deal with. And Korie and I got to play ourselves, which is nice, and talk about our faith, which was fairly natural. I did have to get used to sticking with a script, which I'm not used to. And I did my first take, and they said, Willie, that was great. Now, this time, let's try to do it the way we wrote it. And so I had to make the adjustment.
He had to actually memorize the lines.
I was like back in seminary.
So it wasn't ad-lib. You were reading from a script.
It was, well, I think they made it natural. They put some of the ad-lib in there, but, we definitely had to hit the points and hit the timing right. And, we thought the script was phenomenal. Just some of the situations are, it's just everyday stuff, you know, and it takes it from all sorts of different perspectives. And I thought they did a great job with this film.
Well, you two are parents, and so you're obviously concerned with what's going on when children go off to school. What are you doing to try to prepare them?
You know, I think it comes from teaching from a young age. You know, and just seeing how we live. We've never been ashamed of our faith, and so our kids aren't either, and we're really proud of, you know, how they're growing up and seeing them share their faith and really use the platform that they've been given for God is really incredible for us to see.
Well, Korie and I, we were married young, 19 and 18, so I practically raised her. And so she was like my first child that I raised, and she turned out good. The rest of them are falling in great as well.
Willie, I hate to break
it
to you.
Don't believe it.
Willie, I hate to break it to you, but I think it's the other way around.
Yeah, thank you.
have your children seen the film?
Yes, we actually had a big preview party last week, and we invited everyone from Duck Commander office, gave everybody the afternoon off to come to the movie theater, and the whole family came out, and we filled up a theater and really had a great time. The kids, let the kids invite friends, and it's a really, really great movie. We're very proud to be a part of it.
Well, and we all went to see Son of God together, and the advertisement for God's Not Dead came on, and that was pretty surreal sitting there when the ad came on, because I wasn't expecting that, and I thought this is getting weird whenever you're seeing yourself on the big screen. But that's a great movie, and God's Not Dead. It's a great year for faith-based movies. We're just happy to be a part of it.
It is, and it's also a great year for faith-based television. And thank you for all you're doing. You've really raised the bar on how influential Christian television can be. So thank you for that. You guys got any plans to do a movie of your own?
I don't know. We're just, we'll keep looking at opportunities as they come along. We do a lot of filming, so it's kind of tough to fit all this filming in. But who knows? You know, we're interested now and being a part of, you know, that, being out in Los Angeles for the awards as well. That was neat to see. And, you know, we did Last Man Standing on ABC. We did, there was some great stuff in there with Faith Based. And so we're encouraged by all this. And, again, we're glad God put us in the role, and we're going to try to do the best we can.
Well, again, thank you for all you do. And as the son of a father who likes to speak his mind, I feel you. I know what it's
you
like.
You get it.
I know what it's like for the whole family, and you got to have these family meetings and get together. Okay, this is the latest.
Dad made Christmas very interesting last year. So.
Yeah. Anyway, stand strong. I know you are, and we appreciate you. You got us in your corner. Well, God's Not Dead opens in theaters across the country on March 21st. To find out where it'll be playing in your area, go to cbnnews.com.